Father, we pray that your presence, which is already in this house today, would fill us to overflowing. Bless us. Thank you for the women who lead out in this service today. Minister Donna and Women's Ministry. Thank you for the faithful witnesses of our women in this church and beyond. Bless this government for the Bahamas today. Bless its many institutions. Keep us, Lord. Protect us, Lord. We need you, Lord. We appreciate you so very much. As I stand here today, Lord, help me that I'm not seeing that you're seeing. As I speak, Lord, that I'm not hurting the children. Father, you brought us to this place not to challenge us, not to change us, Lord. So help us, Lord, and let me leave this place, Lord, we're not merely receptive, but responsive to what you are saying. Bless your name. In the name of Jesus Christ, and all of God's people say it. Amen. Amen. I thank the Lord for this wonderful theme today. And the theme assigned is, let's celebrate freedom. And my topic today is the disciplines of freedom. The disciplines of freedom. On this, the eve of the 44th anniversary of independence, I join the chorus of those who wish every success for our beloved Bahama land. Back in 1973, on July 10th, no one was quite sure as to what lay ahead for the Bahamas as we joined other independent nations which were much older and more experienced than us. But 44 years later, look where God has brought us. We are far from perfect, but at the same time, we have come a long way. For this and other blessings, we say to God be the glory. There are many things that will have to come together for us to be one Bahamas. But the fact that we are not quite there as yet, as a nation, is nothing for us to be ashamed of. Indeed, had it not been from the Lord on our side, well, I remain hopeful that if we pull together and allow God to once again be the head of our covenant, we would see restoration in all those areas of national life that have created much concern in the past. As believers in Christ, we too have our role to play in building one nation under God. I want us to hear this message today. Perhaps it's not going to be a very long one. Maybe not a lot of animation, but I want us to pay attention, because many times we get it wrong in this country. We blame institutions. We blame governments. We blame the police. We blame other bodies. And as believers in Christ, many times it escapes us that we have, or it escapes us, that we have a role, a clearly defined role to play in an independent nation. And so I say again, as believers in Christ, we too have a role to play in building one nation under God. In fact, sacred scripture puts it like this: if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray, seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and heal their land. 2 Chronicles 7:14. When God says something, he means it. He wants to bless our people and this land. But as long as we take for granted that we can do any and everything, nothing will happen for us. If you want the blessings of God, if you want the presence of God, if you want the anointing of God in the national affairs of this country, then we must be a people who seek after God. freedom as far as being people of the Word of God. We must serve the one and only true and living God. We must serve the one and only true and living God. Exodus 20, verses 3 to 5 says, "Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image, or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord, thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me." Exodus 20, 3 through 5. What they've been doing somewhere else before they came to this place. Now you're in the church where we preach righteousness and holiness today. And so we stay. But I say that we cannot say we have a relationship with God while at the same time romancing the devil. No wonder so many of our young people are the way they are. It's because of what they see in us. How many people cannot tell you the last time they fell on their face and asked God for his guidance? But you want an effective nation. You want a successful nation. But we have to live righteously and holy before God. We have to take the responsibility that as far as freedom is concerned, it's more than simply saying we are a free nation, but we must be one people under God in righteousness. How faithful and how loyal have you been? Do you find it easy to excuse and explain the worship of things? Some people, when you invite them to church, Bishop Woodley, what they will tell you is that, look at the pastor. They can tell you about everybody else's sin. But they never seem to turn the mirror on themselves. Some people refuse to serve God because they can tell you how many hypocrites are in church. Anyone can complain, but the dean, you're a senior manager in the Royal Bahamas Police Force. You remain focused. Some people may want your job. Say amen, please. Just say amen. Tells us that if we serve God, Ambition is good, but when it begins to eat at your core values and threatens your work with God, your walk with God, it is no longer good. Some people are too busy to come to church. They're always working. Be careful. Be careful. Accomplishments are good, but when they get in the way of our worship, then they are not worthy of celebration. I am so glad that on this Independent Sunday, Senior Assistant Commissioner, you brought all of these offices, and all of them are people with big rights. Big rights. Don't let it get to your head. But it must be here. Riches in your head. Just the other day, all those people walking around and two on the shoulder. You can't forget God. You need to serve God in spirit and in truth. You team, congratulations to all of you who are elevated. I'm really proud to see some of you because some of you want to start right under me. But I want to tell you, keep serving God. Keep calling upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. No elevation, no promotion. It's what the paper that is written on in your can't serve God.
Hallelujah.
Keep serving.
Bishop, you don't know how difficult it is. Bishop, to get up tomorrow morning, it's a holiday, and you'll get up and go back to sleep. Because the body clock, the body's clock, works like that. But oh, we must serve God. We must serve God. Get up in the morning, seek God, call upon His face, call upon His name. Having goals and objectives are good, but when they distort our view of God, then it is time them to replace. Oh God, help us not to try and sanctify the ways of the world and disguise them as godly virtues. You see, a lot of things that used to be in the world are coming to the church now, my friend. And we try to find ways to explain these things. Wrong is wrong. If wrong is wrong, is wrong. You can't explain to me wrong is wrong. Can I live right? Can I live right? Have to live right. Our goals was never usurp the presence and the authority of God in our life. The world will always be the world, but we do not have to follow its dictates. The people call you what they want to call you. As a pastor, I have called everything Bishop with me. When they say, accept a child of God. But you can't let people screw you off. You have to serve God. Look at someone and say, serve God. You don't think anyone is going to speak highly of you? Some people can't think to turn their back on you, to assassinate your character. But you must serve God in spirit and in truth. And that means you're tough. You must find a praise or a prayer and ask God to help you. I went earlier last week, Bishop Whitney, and it was manners to go to the sports center and Lyndon Baker, is turning in his position as the chairman of the National Sports Committee. He invited me. And Bishop Whitney, I heard he was speaking to me so highly. And you know, like some people, when they have me, they ask that, well, let's go to dinner. Let's do, you know what he said? I will have praise. start off with this. And so we had to get the taste. We were praising God, and he asked me to pray. But you know, I have to go 1 second and preach it before I pray. What I'm saying is that we need to lift up the name of Jesus wherever you go. Let your light so shine for God. Some of us only can be Christians in church. But oh, when you go to work on Tuesday morning, then you can lift up your hands and say, I am a child of God, and I can stand for God all for me. It's just something about you. It's just something about you. No funny talk, no dirty talk, but just being consistent for God. And I hug Lyndon, and I rub his head. And you know what I said to people? I said, thank you all for recognizing someone from the Church of God of Prophecy in this way. The minister of sports and all these other big high-polluting people there. But man, and that time tears coming down his little face and all that. And I said, thank you, Jesus, let the tears flow. Do you understand what I'm saying? I am saying wherever you are in this country, in this nation, be a faithful witness for the Lord Jesus Christ. Many people may not like you, but you praise God. Many people may not invite you to their events, but you praise God. The songwriter says, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him. Because there is nothing that this world can take from you. If God says you're blessed, Brother Johnson, the next step in the discipline of freedom is the prominence and preeminence of the Word of God. The prominence and the preeminence of the Word of God. James 1:25 says, but whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty, I'm almost done, and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. In many congregations, this Peter's Bible is quickly becoming irrelevant. People are substituting scripture for motivational talk. Watch on WhatsApp. Very few people now setting on the Word of God. But people are sending you motivational things and how to make you feel good about yourself and how to lift your self-esteem. We need Jesus. We don't need a motivational speaker. We need Jesus. Look at someone else. Some of that stuff I don't even open. I just hit the lead quick right now. Get that foolish on. I want the Word of God. This is what I want. I want the Word of God. Amen. Someone says, give me Jesus, and I am satisfied. I preach a little more now. So in many congregations, the Bible is quickly becoming irrelevant. And even worse, there are many believers who do not regard the Bible as their final source of God's authority. Watch these prayer meetings. Okay, ma'am, watch these prayer meetings. The Lord tells you something in his word. You go to Mother So-and-so in the prayer meeting. Mother So-and-so says, this is what the Lord is telling me. God does not contravene his word. In some of the prayer meetings, we'll sit down and have lunch. So I'm going to finish. Bring me PC and husband clothes. Let me pray over that. That's the devil. One time, Mr. Frank, I in my office. I still woke up walking through the door backwards. I said, in the name of Jesus, turn around. Why you trip down the floor to the city center? We need to trust in God and not be a superstitious people. We need to take God with us. Amen. Look at someone and say, take God with you. Take God.
said, draw me in your pride and this other thing and all that stuff. Stop it in Jesus' name. This walk is Jesus.
This walk is Jesus. In the kingdom. And you grab the Holy Ghost. And you're afraid of what people, you don't know someone they have hand.
What hand? I want God's hand on me.
And I think you want it on you also.
So many people have their own opinion of everything in Scripture that does not line up with their lifestyle. But let me say this much. God's word is God's word. It will never change. In fact, if you follow God's word, you will be changed. Stop looking for ways to circumvent the word of God. There is no shortcut. There is no back door. There's no track road. There's no low wall. There's no other standard. I love many things about the word.